Fujisawa Shukunanda passed away on May 8th to 9 at the age of 83 in Tokyo. I'm sure all going enthusiasts will be saddened by the news. The video today is made for Fujisawa Shuku to impress my grief for his passing. I hope that he will be with the game of Go in heaven. Fujisawa Shuku was the strongest player of his time. He won the KZ 6 times consecutively and was named honorary KZ for life. He excelled at forward thinking and was considered to play the best first 50 moves. His playing style was very smooth and natural. He was respected not only for his skill, but for his character. In spite of all his achievements, he remained modest. He considered Go profound and magnificent. One thing I can command, at most 1% of the essence of Go. During his career, Japan was the strongest country for the game of Go, leaving China and Korea far behind. As the top Go player, he came to China as many as 14 times. Each time he came, he brought nearly 20 young Japanese players as an academic exchange. What's more, he paid all expenses out of his own pocket. China didn't give him money, nor did the Nikon King. It was true selflessness. Yinping Nandan, Ma Xiaochun Nandan, Chen Hao Nandan, three top players in China, were among his students. He also urged Chinese players to send their game records to Japan, so he could review them and help them improve. He not only guided Chinese players, but also gave what he could do to Korean players. Chao Hyunhyun Nandan learned a great deal from Fujisawa. He contributed greatly to the rise of China and Korea in Go. He was truly a great man, worthy of the title Go Master. In 1984, the China-Japan Super Match was underway. There were many who didn't understand why Fujisawa helped Chinese players during the match. In fact, Fujisawa's insight into Go went beyond winning or losing and beyond national boundaries. Compared with the pursuit of truth in Go, which country the players are from, or who wins or loses, is of trifling importance. The video discusses the final match of the China-Japan Super Match in 1985. After beating Katamaso Nandan and Kobayashi Koichi Nandan successfully, Yinping Nandan beat Fujisawa Shuku in the final match. Afterwards, Yinping was titled Go Sage by Chinese government. He was the first top Chinese player in modern Go. At the time, it was the strongest matchup between Go Masters of China and Japan. Originally, I considered competing on the match between Fujisawa Shuku and Masakato Nandan, which is the best one for Fujisawa. But I ultimately chose this match. It's a splendid match, even though Fujisawa lost in the end. I hope Fujisawa will not mind me choosing a match that he lost to commemorate his life. I think the progress of Chinese Go is the best tribute to him. After the rise of China and Korea in Go, Japan no longer feels lonely in the Go world. Yinping Nandan said afterward that he had considered not competing with all his strengths in this match. At the time, Fujisawa was almost 60 years old and was recovering from a recent operation. Fujisawa was also his respected senior and teacher. But he ultimately decided to spare no effort to compete for the win. For one thing, the match was for the honor of the national team. For another, it was the best payback to his teacher to give his best effort. In the end, they both performed splendidly and left a game record that can truly be called a classic. Yinping Nandan takes black. Fujisawa Shuku Nandan takes white. 3-3. comical, comical. White cackle here. White can also consider a splitting move. Black attaches underneath. New piece playing style is fond of territory, so he chose this your statue. Now there are two good points on the board, here and here. If black makes a two-spaced extension directly, then if white jumps, black could take center to kakaru here. If white tanuki, black could invade here afterwards. After this, white kosumi, black came out here or here. If the game goes like this, it would be another game. In actual game, black kakaru here. If white makes a two-space extension, black could tanuki to handle the left side. So white play here as a probe. This move is very common in these days. Actually, this move first appeared in this game. It's an invention of Fujisawa Nandan. No one played like this before this game. Now black had various choices. If black descends, white hane, black hane, white nobi, black nobi, white hane, black hane, white nobi. White shape is very solid and got so much territory. This shape is much better for white than playing a two-space extension. If black nobi here, now white's two-space extension becomes center. If black ignore it, white will nobi. Black's corner will have no territory. If black nobi here, white cross, black hane, white hane. White can also got a lot of territory. If black hane, white clamps, black knights. In this situation, if we take off these two stones, then we will find this exchange is very bad for black. In actual game, black hane here and white cross cut. If black enter here, white enter, black knights, white enter, black captures. In the original shape, black could play here, make a two-space extension to threat white at the weak point here. But after these exchanges, obviously, now black can't play here.